Yeah, make sure I've got my focus all correct. I probably had that zoomed in actually. Got used to using a zoom. I can see it now on the actual lens. Physically see that it's actually zoomed out. So that's good. But here's that infamous roundabout that so confused me the other night, and shouldn't it? Now, last night I made a rather impassioned video complaining about my taxi driver who absolutely stuck me around. He took the taxi down Pasteur Street, and then I'm trying to say to him, keep motioning, turn right, because I need to get to the street running parallel where I live. And he just ignores me, and then he finally says, one-way street. He knew that much English to say. I'm thinking, well, I gave him the address. He knows where he's supposed to go. Why did he choose to take a one-way street? He knew he'd have to divert all the way around to get back to my place. Unless he was just trying to fudge an extra fare. And if he was, it didn't work because I decided just to bail out once we went past where I was supposed to get off because I was so pissed off. I can see why I got a bit confused here. I think I might just go down Pasteur, you know. I was going to try a different route, but I'm running a bit late. And this should actually take me into Pasteur Street, hopefully. And I just don't want to stuff around with any more lost time, to be honest with you. I'll do my little diversion walk some other day. But I think I just kept walking around the roundabout. Like, because I took the wrong exit, I started walking west into totally unknown territory. Definitely haven't done that this time. I'm pretty sure I'm going towards Pasteur. I don't know. This guy's trying to sight, so I don't know what he's trying. Oh, I just had some of the walks I have around here so frustrating. God, you can hear the kids. Plenty of kids in this car. Yeah, they don't mind being photographed. As long as they don't. You know, we're not as paranoid about paranoia up here as we are in Australia. I'll be okay. These days, you'd have to question having any kid in the shop. Because your motives are not regarded as being pure, that's for sure. I think we're in Pasteur now, thank God. God, they're noisy kids. At least I'm not living next to them like I usually do. You always seem to cop a bloody apartment next to a school. So this is Pasteur Street during the day. Very attractive, and there's still plenty of bloody bikes coming down here. This is only 3 o'clock again. Schools are about to come out. I think maybe these are parents coming to pick up kids. I don't know. But there's a lot of traffic this time of day. I think it tapers off for about an hour, then it's full on again for peak hour, so yeah. Here we get walking up to that. I took a shot of these cherry blossoms the other day. Might as well do a moving shot towards them. Some sort of a festival, presumably. I don't know. If I learnt the lingo, I could find all this stuff out, couldn't I? Learning enough words to order food. The basics. I don't think they're artificial, I think they're real trees. I've no idea, I'm only guessing. But yeah, it's some sort of a festival, I think. And here's some guy backing into me, great. They come every direction, every single direction, you're just a target. Yeah, the war's not over, it's still happening. It's just a difference in urban war these days. The war of survival. There you go. How about they drive into you? I can't believe it. Seriously, I've had people divert into me. I mean, they're actually targeting me. Craziness. I had a couple of security guards do that yesterday. One guy my path was clear and he just jumps out right in front just to block my way. Just staggering. Gets bloody frustrating. I mean, it's a nice city to walk around, but there are so many people. It seems there's more people every time I come here. And this city is bursting with people. And I don't think you can afford to wait two or three more years for that metro to open. It's just going to get really brutal. But of course, they don't have elections over here, so they can't exactly complain like we can. But I don't know. It's not good. It's a pretty over. Yeah, they're going to have to do something about their infrastructure, but, you know, I can't exactly talk. I mean, well, Cairns is fine. It's such a small place. But Melbourne's got real issues there too. And they're not building one big enough. Apparently London's building this huge new underground. It's just traffic everywhere. Yeah, I'm not even sure why I'm making tracks to this. It's the first AFL game of the year, and my team, Richmond's playing, but they're garbage. Apparently they're fancy, big time to beat Carlton, so who knows. Just what the commentators say, though, they know bugger all. They're about as good as the financial commentators in our country. You got morons like, what I regard as a moron is Dwayne Russell. What a big mouth. Full of BS, that guy. So I was listening to 3AW. It's the only time I'm listening to it for ages. I've never listened to Melbourne radio anymore. It's crap. So, I'm severing ties in my old city. Yeah, culturally. Just have no connection with it. And my interest in AFL isn't as great as it used to be. It's okay. But I did like the grand final. That was good because that was an underdog. Pardon the pun, being Footscray, best Western Bulldogs won the grand final. It's always good to see the underdog win a big match, no matter what the sporting contest is. So that was good. But the AFL pissed me off a bit these days. They're so politically correct. There seems to be some sort of a cause attached to virtually every match now. And that pisses me off. Why can't we go back to the old days and we just played football for football's sake, for the sport? Not turn into some political bloody... You know, it's getting as bad as Hollywood celebs who each have to basically push their own political barrow every 5 minutes. They seem to be just a pack of frustrated politicians who love to preach to lowlifes like us who aren't in the Hollywood elite. And I think the AFL's getting a bit... Well, it's that corporate culture we have these days in many areas. Not just AFL, many companies. So, and most of the corporates are pretty gutless when it comes to issues. It was the same-sex thing. Like there was some controversy with an advertisement with Cooper's Brewing Company. And Cooper's, just rather than stand up for their principles, they just caved to what they thought was the perceived public mood. And I think they got it wrong, actually. They want to be very careful pandering to sectional interests, because there's a lot of lobby groups out there that don't represent the mainstream, that they've got very loud voices, and stupid politicians and corporates think that's actually a real indication of their influence and their size. It's just BS. The penny will drop eventually. But, Australia's a bit of a sad case at the moment, in my opinion. I'm not a happy boy. I love being up here. It refreshes me, quite all the little irritations. I still enjoy being here. It's refreshing for me. Maybe if I went back to Oz back in the 1950s, I'd be a bit happy. I mean, certain things I'd be very unhappy about, but certain aspects about values and what have you, I think I'd probably enjoy it more. I think our moral compass has been pretty broken the last few years. So, I think Asians have got their act together compared to us in a few ways. And this economy's growing. I think their population probably is growing, but nowhere near as fast as ours, probably, because we're just adding population through immigration, which we can't build the infrastructure to handle it. So that's a joke. But if anybody ever questions our immigration level, you're labelled a racist, which is absurd. And apparently, I heard on the radio that even Bob Brown confided privately that's how he felt, that the Greens weren't allowed to bring up that topic because they'd be labelled racist, even though naturally speaking, you would think it would be in the Green agenda to keep the population down, given what they're trying to achieve. But no, because of PC, they're too scared to actually do anything about it. This guy's going to walk right in. It happens all the time. People just wander across. They don't look. In a daze. Okay, just heading to... Yeah, see this? Bumper to bumper. This is the new metro station they're building. You know, you see the outside. Actually, they've blocked this bit off since yesterday. Oh, that's got worse. You used to be able to walk around there. If they do it this way, it's real. I don't know what they're doing. They're pumping something, I guess. But, they closed that off last... Maybe overnight they open this up, because I normally make access then. But, yeah, look at this. It's causing a bit of trouble with traffic. Now you've got a very narrow roadway through. I'll be able to get through, luckily, very quickly. That was good, but not easy. Actually, I did have the right of way, not that means much over here. And all this whole area, and it's a coved Vietnam-Japanese construction project. And there's some crap happening here. You can see a vacant block. They dug a huge trench back there, and they shut off a lot of the central city for a while and split it down the center, like East-West Berlin job. But that's all, it's not as nearly partitioned as it was, it's a bit better. But there's still a lot of activity happening, and it's happening slowly. I think it should have been open this year or next, and now it's gonna be a few years off. Like I said, they really need that metro. And this is Pasteur Street, heading down towards where the bars are. The other bar I'm going to today, the Game On, is actually just around the corner from most of the bars, so it's in that same area. So yeah, it'd be interesting to see how much football I can stomach. I can watch Richmond. They're pretty ambivalent. We've had the same coach, seems like 20 years. They're not allowed to apparently change the coach these days. They got a lot of stick by changing coaches regularly. And they thought the solution would be to get the one coach. Well, it hasn't been a great success, so not sure if that actually plays out the way they expected. But humans make mistakes all the time. We just stumble through life. So actually, I'm heading up now to where Tequila Bar is. It's just over here on the left. So this is it during the day. See the exterior. Getting pretty close now. There you go, there's Tequila's exterior. Of course, they're not open yet. And nearly every bar's shut, except number 5 bar is open at 3. There's my nemesis, cheers. And now I've got to try to get through these bikes. Oh, Jesus, obstacles everywhere in the city. There's people everywhere. It's the way it is. So that's a bit of old town in the corner there. That's interesting, with all the foliage up top. It's not bad. Gotta just go a little bit further. I'm gonna be slightly late, I reckon. Probably about 5 minutes. Not too bad. That place over there, the emergency room, still going. I don't get it. Is there a fetish about watching, looking at girls serving your drinks wearing surgical masks? Bizarre. Takes all kinds, I guess. It's been in business for years, so they must be doing something right. I thought it'd be a novelty factor job and light and close in a few weeks. Maybe they're doing real emergencies. Maybe it's actually a paramedic outfit now. Yeah, no, this area. Well, I've stayed in this area many times. Over that direction there, towards the big tower. And that's where Game On is as well. There's a little market just there to the right. Not a great market. I don't think I've actually ever bought anything there. Oh, that looks like it's a rooftop bar up there. Oh, that wouldn't be bad. It's in a pretty good location. Hadn't noticed that before. So this is a pretty heavily touristed area around here. High concentration of hotels. The only downside for me is it's convenient for the bars, but you want to get a decent feed, you'll pay a little more and you won't get the authentic Vietnamese experience. You know, there is a corner place. It's okay food-wise. The food's fine. It's just a bit more expensive. But, you know, considering you're right in the centre of town, it's pretty reasonable. And this guy's bloody looking. He's mobile. Doesn't know where I am. And just another big skyscraper up there. Another one there. And more being constructed. And more bikes. And if I get through this one, we'll finally get to the point. Now, it just should be a walk, a simple walk, to Game On. This is all new construction here. It's building something new here. This was not here last time I was here. Stay away 6 months and the streetscape can change radically. So Game On is just down the road here. Should be coming into frame any second now. Oh, it's just here actually. There it is. With the fighting kangaroos. Are they fighting? Or are they? No, they've got boxing gloves on. So this is Game On. And they've got the TripAdvisor thing in there. And hopefully they've got the footy on. Oh yeah, there's AFL. Beautiful. That's what I'm looking for. I'm gonna get some cold. Get a Saigon. It looks like Richmond's kicked the goal.